President Marcos led the grand opening of the new terminal building of the Clark International Airport. Our very own Joyce Balancho is there, and she now joins us with that story. Joyce, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. attended a program for the grand opening of a new terminal building here at the Clark International Airport in Mabalacat City, Pampanga. He led the ribbon cutting as well as the unveiling of the marker of the project with First Lady Liza Marcos as well as Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco and Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista. In his speech, he recognized the project as the perfect example of a good collaboration between the government and the private sector, since this is a product of a public-private partnership deal. Marcos said that his administration is planning to pursue more projects such as this. In fact, he mentioned that in his recent trips abroad, he encouraged business groups and investors to collaborate with the Philippine government to mount such projects. He added that the administration has plans to improve and decongest the airport in Manila while boosting regional airports in Bohol, Cagayan de Oro, Cebu, and Davao. More direct domestic and international flights will be opened in these airports, he said. Marcos, however, was quick to admit that this is not a project of his administration, but nonetheless, he recognized how this can help the Philippine economy in general. The new terminal building was funded during the Aquino administration, but it was the Duterte government that constructed this. It was finished in 2020 and was partially operational on May 2022. The government boasts of its facilities and features, mainly the contactless system for self-check-in, flight selection, baggage check, and among others. The Department of Transportation said this new terminal building can accommodate 8 million passengers annually and will definitely help decongest Ninoy Aquino International Airport in Metro Manila. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Joyce Balancho there joining us live. The low-pressure area off extreme northern Luzon has developed into a tropical depression. Let's get more details now from ABS-CBN's resident meteorologist, Ariel Rojas. Ariel.
Good afternoon, Carmina. The low-pressure area that entered the Philippine area of responsibility 6 p.m. last night developed into a tropical depression and was assigned the local name Luis. It was last spotted 1,100 kilometers east of extreme northern Luzon with maximum winds of 55 kilometers per hour and gusts up to 70 kilometers per hour. It is moving northwestward at a speed of 25 kilometers per hour. The good news is Tropical Depression Luis will neither make landfall over nor affect the weather in the country, and it may leave the Philippine area of responsibility tomorrow morning. However, another low-pressure area is being monitored, located 445 kilometers east of Diwan, Eastern Samar. Pagasa says this disturbance will dissipate within 24 to 48 hours. However, today, it will bring moderate to heavy rains in eastern Visayas, Caraga, and Davao region. On the other hand, the southwest monsoon or Habagat will also bring scattered rains over occidental Mindoro, Palawan, and western and central Visayas. Intense thunderstorms will also form this afternoon in Ilocos Region, Cordillera, Central Luzon, Cavite, Batangas, Northern Mindanao, and Sokcergen. Metro Manila will have sunny breaks but will also experience thunderstorms this afternoon and evening. In the coming days, the Habagat will withdraw to the West Philippine Sea and the warm easterlies will take over. That's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Ariel Rojas there. The death toll from Typhoon Karding has now risen to 10. Our correspondent Bianca Dava now joins us for more on that. Bianca, go ahead.
Carmina, two more fatalities were recorded from the onslaught of Super Typhoon Karding, bringing the death toll to 10. The new fatalities were reported in Baliwag, Bulacan, and Tanay, Rizal, with both of the victims dying due to drowning, according to NDRRMC spokesperson Rafi Alejandro. But Alejandro added, the numbers are still up for verification. The number of missing has meanwhile reached 8. These include the 5 fishermen in Mercedes Camarines Norte, 2 more individuals in Antipolo Rizal, and another in Quezon Province. Damage to public infrastructure due to Karding has reached over 23 million pesos, according to the NDRRMC. In its 8 a.m. situational report on Wednesday, the NDRRMC said damage to roads and bridges in Ilocos Region, Mimaropa, and Cordillera Administrative Region account for majority of the affected protected structures. Car incurred the biggest damage at 19.6 million pesos. Mimaropa had 3 million pesos in infrastructure damage and Region 1 at 450,000 pesos. However, other areas have yet to fully assess the damage as relief and clearing operations are currently the main focus of operations. Affected houses across regions in Luzon are more than 3,000 with 2,400 partially damaged and we have some 630 totally destroyed. Now close to 40,000 families or 157,000 individuals were affected by the onslaught of Karding, of which a total of 8,825 families are still remaining in evacuation centers. The NDRRMC also reported that more than 5.5 million pesos worth of assistance was already provided to affected individuals, and the aid consisted of food, family packs, hot meals, and financial assistance, among others.